بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Welcome back to my channel QHE تجويد Rules of the Quran channel in English. Today inshallah we will go through some mistakes in تفخيم and ترقيق chapter in the heavy and light letters. I heard from especially non-Arab. These mistakes, it's especially from non-Arab. Arab people, they have different mistakes than that, subhanAllah. So this is not all the mistakes, but it's most of it, or it's some of it. Let's go check together these mistakes and see the mistakes that happen in tafkhim and tarqiq. My first mistake here, when you depends in your tafkhim, in your lips. Circling the lips when they say mufakham or heavy letters. Some people, to make the tafkhim, they use their lips by circling it or move it somehow to make the letter more mufakham. This is their thinking. This is wrong thought, because tafkhim, it depends in the tongue from the back how high it is. The tafkhim letter, one more time, the tafkhim letter. To make any letter mufakham, what I need only, I need to raise my tongue from back. If I imagine this is the palate of the mouth, to make the letter mufakham, this is my tongue. My tongue should to touch the soft area from the palate of the mouth from the back. And compressed the sound between these two area. And compressed the sound between these two areas. So the tongue should to be up from the back, and I should to compress the sound between these two areas, so the sound will go up, hit the palate of the mouth, back with the echo. This echo, this is the reason of the tafkhim of the letter. Inshallah, this is clear for you. This is how the tafkhim happen. This is the tongue, and this is the palate of the mouth. So tafkhim is not coming at all from the lips. It's just coming from the back of the tongue. With what? With the soft area from the palate. You can back for articulation point and know more about it, inshallah. Let's see examples here to see how should I read it with the right way. Some people read instead of balsir, they say bal, balsui, balsui. Did you hear the different sound? It's almost sound there is dhamma instead of kasra. Balsui, it should to be balsui, balsui. Okay. Al-qitr, al-qitr, qitr, not al-qitr. Al-qitr, wrong. Al-qitr, this is the right one. What else? Nudhiqh, not nudhiqh, nudhiqh, this is wrong. What else? Rabbi, not ra, rabbi, this is wrong. So this is cause, this circling of the lips, it's cause closer sound to dhamma, sometimes complete dhamma, and in both cases this is wrong. How can I fix this problem? Practice your heavy letter in front of mirror and be sure your lips is not circling even a little bit. This is how you fix this mistake. Second mistake we see in tarqiq and tafkhim, the letter alif. And this is very common with non-Arab people, especially the beginner and the middle level. What's this mistake is? Making the alif heavy or light when they should not. What I mean by that? We said letter alif, it's followed the letter before it. If the letter before alif, it's heavy, I should to make this alif heavy. If the letter before it light, I should to make this alif letter light. The mistake I heard in this alif, for example, word wa asalna, people read it wa asalna, Na. Did you hear this alif? Wrong. Or wa'asalna. This is wrong. It should to be wa'asalna. Na. Alif is just alif, but it's light. Word azab, it's not aza. It's aza, not aza. Or aza. Okay, this is wrong. What else? Bi'asa. This is should to be heavy. Bi'asa, not bi'asa. Bi'asa. Bi'asaka, not bi'asaka. Okay, and I heard it a lot too. Qala, not qala. So alif should to follow the letter before. Qa, not qa. Sa, not sa. Aza, the, not the. Na, not na. Inshallah, this is clear for you. Next mistake I heard too. The letter ra, and this letter ra, I don't know why it has يعني, a problem with a lot of people, subhanallah al-azim. We explained it in several classes before. You can back for the rules of ra under the chapter of tafkhim and tarqiq. You will find around 6 videos at least about letter ra. You can watch all of them to see everything about ra and when we make it muraqqaqa and when we make it mufakhama. Plus you can see the video of the mistakes it happened in letter ra and how can we fix it. One of the mistakes here, it's not in the video before, some people making the ra all the time muraqqaqa or making the ra mufakhama or muraqqaqa when they should not to be like that. Like what? Like word fir'auna. I hear some people say fir, fir. Why you make this ra heavy? It should to be light because it's a sakina and the letter before it is kasra. So it should to be fir, not fir. This is number one. Second mistake in word bismillahir rahmanir rahim. This is two ra in this ra shadda and this is two ra in this ra shadda. Both of them should to be heavy. Not the first one light and the second one heavy. Some people say arra, 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 arra. This is wrong. Or arra. This is wrong too. So both ra should to be heavy here. If I have ra with shadda, I follow the haraka in this ra and I make the ra heavy or light. What else? Word. رب العالمين. A lot of people say رب, رب. I heard it a lot. Plus, if some people follow all the time, the ra is light. And this is very common for non-Arab too. A lot of time, the ra is light, 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 light. Never come heavy. And when you tell them, they starting to mix between heavy and light ra. If they study the rules of ra and focus on it very carefully, they can avoid this problem, inshallah. Next, النبر على الراء الساكنة غير المشددة والعكس. This is a little bit, يعني advanced level. Making the ra ساكنة مشددة when they stop on it, or the reverse. What I mean by that? To see an example here, word والفجر. وَلَيَالٍ عَشَّرُ. This is the ra when I stop on it heavy. Some people make it how? وَالْفَجَرُ وَلَيَالٍ عَشَّرُ. This is wrong. This is wrong. It's not shadda. It's just regular ra and it's heavy. How can I read it again? وَالْفَجَرُ وَلَيَالٍ عَشَّرُ وَالشَّفْعِ وَالْوَتْرُ وَالْلَيْلِ إِذَا يَسْرُ. This is how I should to read it. By this, our class for today is done, but our mistake in the tafkhim and tarqiq is not done yet. Today, we talked around 5 mistakes. Next time, inshallah, we will talk about 6 more mistakes about tafkhim and tarqiq. Jazakumullah khairan to watch my channel, QHE Tajweed Rules of the Quran channel in English. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, and share, and click the bell to get every video, every new video every day. Plus, write the comment to me so I can know, inshallah, what's your thinking at what and what you want from me to do for you. All the videos links for the tafkhim and tarqiq, you will find it in description of the video. Jazakumullahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.